It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Dietz family. Carl, Donna, Norman, Sharon, and Eloise, ready for action. And the Sturgis family. Steve, Todd, Mark, Doug, and Tom, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Culkin.
I'm not going to mess around up here because we got kind of an exciting, special little story with this family. We got $10,000 to give away to Dietz family. Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Introduce everybody and then we'll talk.
Okay, Richard, this is my lovely wife, Donna.
Hi,
hello,
Richard.
My darling.
This is my long-lost brother, Norman.
Norman.
Richard. His lovely wife, Sharon.
Sharon.
And Sharon's mother, Eloise.
Hi, Richard.
That's a part of the story that we're about to hear. I've just heard a little bit of it that I understand that you got separated. But tell me all about, tell me what happened.
Yes, Richard. When Norm and I were young, we were fostered out and back in Cleveland, Ohio. And in the early 50s, Norm moved out to California and got separated from the family. And and last December, he phoned me and we got back together after 30 years of being separated.
Who started the tracking down?
I can give all the thanks to my sister-in-law, Sharon.
You're the one who said? You deserve a great big hug. I'm sure they've given you one. But...
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm real happy for all of them.
Now, how would you go around? I have no idea how you would go about...
Richard, the way it came about was my husband was baking cookies one night. It was around the holidays, just around after Thanksgiving. And he seemed a little depressed. And I asked him, what's bothering him, you know? And he says, I just want to find my brothers and sisters. You're going to get me going.
Well, I don't want you to cry.
Anyway, so I make a long story short. I started pumping him with information.
Right.
And he remembered a name.
May I
say it?
Of course you can. Why?
Betty and Gil Hinkle of Mentor, Ohio. We called them. He remembered the name. And they, in return, called Carl's foster parents.
I see.
And 2 days later, we had a conference phone call.
Well, then, Carl and Betty, we got to thank, too, because they really helped. That's marvelous.
Betty and Gil.
Oh,
Betty
Gil.
Gil.
That's marvelous.
We love them.
Yeah. I just want to give you a little hug. How you doing?
Great.
You okay? Mm-hmm. Take a lucky lollipop.
Are they real lucky?
Guarantee a winner out of two families.
That's great.
Can't get a better guarantee than that.
No.
Is that the one you want?
Well, I need a few more.
Well, I'll give you some afterwards. Just one for luck. That's the one.
Okay, this is the lucky one.
Hey, that's
Thank
a
you.
Thrilling story. Beautiful, really. Marvelous. Yeah, now these rascals, of course, are touched by your story. They want you to spend more time with each other and lose this game.
Sturgis, right out.
Who got it, son?
Well, I have a kiss for you, Richard.
A kiss?
Yeah.
Wait a second. This is a kiss? I've had kisses this big. Those probably have been lost.
Well, I barely know you, so that's just a little
Well,
kiss.
All right. I shouldn't have kissed you on the first date anyway.
Right.
Let me meet everybody.
Well, I got four of my best friends here tonight. This is Todd, my brother.
Oh, your brother.
My brother, Mark.
Hi, Richard.
My brother, Doug.
Slower. Start this again now.
Okay.
Well, we want to get nice pictures of them. They're good-looking boys. This is Todd.
This is my brother, Todd.
Hi, Richard.
Good to have you here, champ.
My brother, Mark.
Hi, Richard.
Marco.
My brother, Doug.
How you doing, Richard?
Hey.
And my brother, Tom.
Yay, hi, Tom. Richard. How you doing?
And Tom,
you're all looking very good. How are you?
Pretty good.
How old are you, Tom?
16. Richard, this is from me and all my friends at Claremont High.
Oh, that's a pretty neat hat. Thank you. Take a lucky lollipop. Come,
Feud. We'll play the Feud. Let's go.
Yeah. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something that some people are very loyal to.
Church.
Church. Yes, sir. 2 answers will be.
Huh? How about their wife, Richard?
Their wife?
Good.
It's there. Good answer.
Good play, Richard.
Good play, Jim. All right. Come on, Doc. I get to meet the pretty lady. How you doing?
Hi.
Welcome. Something some people are very loyal to.
Home.
Okay. Home. No.
Richard.
Good to have you here, champ.
I'd say work.
Work.
Good.
Work.
Yeah. Oh, nervous one, huh?
Something that some people are very loyal to.
Pets. What the heck?
Pets could be there.
Yeah, I had a pet before I had a child.
Exactly. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Pet. No. Good angel. There's nothing wrong with that answer. Come on, my dog. What are some people very loyal to?
A large organization.
Let's take a look. All right,
all right. Good, good.
That's there, all right. If not, third strike. A lodge.
Yeah. No.
Yeah. Yeah. It's
country. Country.
I need an answer, champ.
We're going to go, you're loyal to your country.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, 49-0. Let's go. Come on. Let's see here. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. Here is the question. Name something that melts when accidentally left in a hot parked car. Yeah.
Ice.
Ice. Something that melts when it's accidentally left in a hot parked car.
Ice cream?
Ice cream. Very good, my wife. Stop and close. Don't play it fast.
Play.
We're going to play. Well done, Val. What would melt accidentally?
Chocolate. All
right. Chocolate? Now, we've got a hot parked car. What melts when you accidentally leave it in there?
Lipstick.
Okay, let's look. Lipstick. What is this, Angel?
That's for you.
Well, what is it then?
Well,
I can't believe that I. Did you make this for me?
I sure did.
Then you probably know what it is. What is it?
You want me to tell you?
Not if it's going to end my career rapidly, dear.
No.
Probably something very sweet because she's a grandmother. What is it?
Richard, this goes over a can of room deodorant. And when after you get it on the can, it looks like a candle.
That's very sweet of you. You've given me several nervous moments here, but I knew it couldn't be anything wrong because she's such a lovely lady. What would melt accidentally when it's left in the Crowman?
I can't think of anything.
Nothing? Three seconds, darling. I gotta give you.
I blank.
Okay. Huh? Thank you. Okay, that's all right. No problem.
That's okay.
Richard, how about some candles?
Very good. Oh, good.
Candles? Oh, well, I thought that was a good answer. What would you say, Don?
Butter, margarine.
Butter? Okay. Good answer. Butter's there, all right. It's not the drop. Butter. No. Good answer. Not for
real.
Records. Records there, you get the 83. If not, Carl does. Records! Yeah! Three, please.
Chase.
Five.
Crown.
Crown. Which I believe this survey was done in, wasn't it? We'll be back right after this. Yeah. 132-0. Let's go. Come on.
Thanks.
100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a part of the body for which people do special exercise.
Yes. The back.
The back. Four answers will beat it.
Man.
Leg.
Yeah.
Got it. Very, very good.
We'll play.
We'll play, Chair. Right. Well done. Good to meet young Doug here. How are you, Chair?
Oh, not okay. Bad, Richard. Pretty good.
Part of the body for which people do special exercise.
You know, Richard, when I was young, I used to, you know, lift a lot of weights with my arms.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're quite old now, guys.
Yeah. You know, once you get past elementary
How
school,
old are
it
you,
sort
guys?
Of wears off. I'm 18.
You have a cruel streak.
I'm available, too, Richard.
Very cruel streak. Arms!
Good answer. Yeah!
Hey, young Tom.
How about stomach?
Sure. Stomach.
Yeah!
Well, everybody, people do special exercise. Say.
I'll say neck.
Okay, neck. First strike. Two answers left. Top.
Come on, Todd.
Let's go, Todd. How about feet, Richard?
Okay, let's look.
Good answer,
hey.
Todd. Good answer.
Let's go, Mark.
Come on, Mark.
Buttocks.
Good answer.
I thought feet was weird, but El Tush.
Yeah!
Come on, Doug. Finish this up for me. Part of the body for which people do special exercises.
How about your brain? Your head, you know, you read a lot.
Don't you think we've all left it a little late? Tell me the truth.
Well, I don't know.
We'll take a look up.
Okay.
If it's there, okay. I do two push-ups a week. No, first. Brain! No! Part of the body. Carl.
Okay, Richard.
Give me the right answer, you get the money.
Okay.
What would you say, sir?
Richard?
Yeah.
How about bust?
Oh, it sounds so lustful, please. If it's there, you get the $95. If not, Steve and the boys, big lead. Bust! 132.95. Let's go! Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a grand prize offered in one of those mail order contests. Yeah.
Car.
Car. One answer will be there.
A house, Richard.
A house to dump. Very fast.
We're going to play, Richard.
Well done. Yeah, those exercises are paying off. Grand prize offered in one of those mail order contests.
How about a boat?
Looking for a good boat.
Good answer.
Not that.
Oh, nice try.
See?
Vacation, Richard.
Ah, sure. Yes. Lovely vacation.
Yeah. Let's do it, Todd.
Todd. 3 seconds, then. Two strikes, one answer left. Come on, you can do it. Grand prize offered in one of those mail order contests. Mark, give me an answer. 3 seconds.
Come on,
give it to me, the game goes on. I need an answer. If it's correct, the game continues. What do you say?
Richard, money.
Money's there, you get the 170. If not, you're the champs. Money!
Yeah!
165, 132, let's go. Come on. We wish you both luck now. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an occupation whose members work in a public school.
Yeah. Doctor.
What?
Doctor.
Doctor.
Teachers.
Pardon?
Teachers.
Teacher. Gonna play a pass.
Play.
Gonna play, kid. All right.
Come on, Paul.
Listen carefully. Donald, Sharon, listen, I'm gonna read it once. I can't repeat it. When I get to you, you got 3 seconds to answer it. Name an occupation whose members work in a public school. Carl, 3 seconds.
Richard, mechanics.
Mechanic.
No. Librarian.
Librarian.
Go on. Gardener.
Gardener, is it there?
Yeah, that's good.
Not that. Three answers. Occupation of members work
Principal,
in public school.
Principal.
Yep. Principal, if it's thou, you're the champs. If not, you are principal. Two, please.
Janitor.
Three.
First.
Four.
Secretary.
No principal. I gotta tell you, I thought these people were going away a long, long time ago, you know. They stole two questions on you, but that last question, they got it because you didn't steal it. That's the secret. I'm gonna give you $250.
Thank you, Richard.
That nice try.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
You
didn't... Thanks, dude. Thank you. Okay. Good. Who's first? Carl and Norman, the long lost brothers, going for the money right after we watch this. Let's win the money.
Okay, Richard.
Make this reunion a biggie. 15 secs, please. Name something specific you buy that's supposed to last for years.
A car.
Something people put on bicycles.
Lights.
A fish you fry.
Salmon.
Something found in a jail.
Prisoner.
A brand of ketchup.
Hunt's.
Turn around. Something as good as you buy, supposed to last for years. Car, you said? Survey said. All right. You can put on bicycles. Light. Survey.
All right.
55. Salmon. Survey said. Ball.
All right.
Something found in a jail. Prisoners. Survey.
All right!
And the ketchup,
hunt.
Everybody said,
all right!
Well, that's your start.
Thank you.
Now, back to the ladies. A little bit Norman. Here's Norman. Come on. 66 points away, champ. That's all you need. Stand right there. We wish you luck. Please remind everyone the answers Carl gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something specific you buy that's supposed to last for years.
TV.
Something people put on bicycles.
Lights.
Try again.
Pedals.
A fish you fry.
Trout.
Something found in a jail.
A bed.
A brand of ketchup.
Hunt's.
Try again.
Del Monte.
Turn around. And this is what you buy that lasts for years. Car was number one. You said TV. Survey said 10. Put on bicycles. Lights is number one. You said pedals. Survey said. No. If it's a good bike, it'll have those on there, yeah. Norm. Fish you fry. You said trout. It was number one. Survey said. You found in a jail. Prisoners, number one. You said a bed. Need 20 points. Survey said. Brand of ketchup. The number one answer was Heinz. Number one answer. You said Del Monte. If it's worth 10 points, you have $10,000. Survey said.
Stand there. Between you now. You hold that. Hold this. I've got a portrait of both of you here.
Oh.
You're holding hands.
Thank you, Richard.
Dietz are together again, folks. We got them, and they've got $10,502.
PSA.
One, two, three, four.
Extreme Dodgeball, tonight at 10 on GSN.
265, 132, let's go. Come on.